and trying to get it there was Greening, but it was too far, and Kane back trying to get around Karlsson. Karlsson did not get much of Kane, but he got a stick, and that was all Kane could do without the lumber. Cleared back deep. Kane now goes in. Kane gives Karlsson a shot in the corner, and Karlsson is slow to get up. Here comes Kane. He goes back to touch it.
You see Erik Karlsson on the break, on the bench, shaking out the cobwebs. Goes for the big hit on Evander Kane. Gets quite a bit of him. Good play. But Evander Kane, we've seen this out of him before. You hit me once, I'm going to come right back after you. He gets his elbow up on Erik Karlsson. That probably should have been a penalty called against Evander Kane. And then right after that,
with one assist in his last 10 games. Kyle Wellwood, one assist in his last 10 games as well. Evander Kane now gets knocked down off the faceoff. Here we go. Mark Stewart, Chris Neal, Evander Kane. And it might be the main event. Might be Neal and Kane. And
this is all, of course, from the hit from Kane on Karlsson in the corner.
Neal with the gloves off. And it will be interesting to see what the calls are now. Kirkner and Stewart. As Chris Neal immediately goes after Evander Kane.
I don't know how you don't give Neal an instigator on that play. Kane still has his gloves on. Starts right off the faceoff. See Matt Kirkner in the penalty box already. He heads to the bench, but right off the faceoff, puck jumps to Evander Kane. That's a clean hit for Chris Neal. Nothing wrong with that, but they come right after him. Mark Stewart comes in, recognizes what's going on with Chris Neal. And then Chris Neal has the gloves off right away. And Evander Kane certainly capable of fighting Chris Neal, but that's not a trade the Winnipeg Jets want to make, sitting Evander Kane in the box for 5 minutes alongside of Chris Neal.
And as you mentioned, wasn't exactly at the ring of the bell, as Neal's gloves were off before Kane got engaged. And it will be interesting.